to make sure that this does not happen, you know, that. Because I don't want that. I don't find that sexy. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm very excited because I am showing you finally the latest palette from Nomad Cosmetics. She's also showing the pictures on her Instagram right now. So, yeah, but in case you missed it, I will show you what the palette looks like in just a second. First, though, I have to mention that this palette was sent to me in PR by Nomad Cosmetics, but I was not required or asked to make a video about it. I just did so because when I saw the inside of the palette, I was like, I'm a need to play with that. Let me just stop yabbering and show you close-ups of the palette. So here you see the outside of the palette, which she has already shown on her Instagram as well. But you don't want to know the outside, you want to know the inside, right? So here is the inside of the palette. And it is just, I think it's just so, so pretty. It's a combination of, I want to say cool and warm tones, but it's not even that, because even the warm tones that you see in the center are not really as warm as they can be. It's a very, very unique color story. Now, a little bit about the palette. You get 15 shades. It's a combination of mattes and shimmers. The palette is cruelty-free and vegan, in case that is important to you. It's always nice to know. If you see the inside of the palette, the names are in English, but on the outer box, let me show you the box. I don't know if you can see the names here, if it will focus, but the names are in Icelandic, and I basically during the ice watch process kind of try to pronounce it a little bit. I think I'm failing miserably though, just saying. I would love to know how to pronounce it, and I have looked it up on several occasions, but I just forget every time, which is kind of a shame. So yeah, I am planning to keep the outer box just because of the extra information that is on here. Also, the ingredients are on the side of the box as well. Yes, let me also show you the arm swatches so you have a complete picture of everything. The palette swatched basically as I am used to from Nomad's formula. So the mattes are pretty soft, but they are still easy to work with, at least in my opinion. I will give you some tips and tricks at the end of the video though. And the shimmers are just gorgeous in this palette as well. There are no satins, it's just mattes and shimmers and a few duochrome shades thrown in too. It's just very, very unique to my collection, and I cannot wait to hear what you guys think about it as well. There is also a timestamp down in the description box. Well, basically there's two, for the eye swatching part in case you want to skip me yabbering, and then for the review part as well. I am going to give you over to my past self for the eye swatching part. At the end of the eye swatching part, I give you some thoughts on that process, and then you will see me again, and I will tell you if I think that the palette is worth it. I will give you some tips and tricks. I also tried the palette with different primers, and I will let you know my favorites to try to use with this palette and why. Tomorrow, 5 looks will go online with this gorgeous palette. This is the last look, so you get a sneak peek of one of the looks as well. Tomorrow the palette will launch. If you want to know the time that the palette is going to be released, check the description box, because as I'm filming this, I'm not really sure. Now is the time to grab a drink and a snack and put your feet up, because here comes the eye swatching part, and I will see you after that. Well, hello and welcome to the eye swatching part of the video. I've already primed my eyes. I'm going to use the Kiko Milano eyeshadow base for this. I've also used this in the looks video, and I really like the way that the shadows perform on top of this primer. It's also a little bit more hydrating, for which my eyes will be pretty grateful, I think. So yeah, for the mattes, I'm going to use, I think, this one. Largely, but I also have something similar from Sigma. It's basically, I don't know, a fluffier packing brush. And then for the shimmers, I have different options as well. I have some water here in case I want to spray. However, I know that I don't really need to spray them, because they will show up nicely when you spray them as well. But if I spray them, it kind of shows you how they perform on top of a glitter primer. So I'll probably spray them. I'm not going to use a glitter primer, because my eyeballs will not like me tomorrow if I do. Yes, let's start with the first shade, which is called Frig. or Frigg. I don't know how to pronounce it in Norwegian or in Icelandic. I do know how to pronounce it in Dutch, but I would say Frigg. I don't think it's correct, but that's okay. It is a minty, and what I noticed first off with the minty, I'm going to pack it on, is that it kind of needs a sticky base. Because in the look, I also put it onto underneath my eye on a set base, and I really needed to pack it on. But that is usually the case for me with pastels as well, just saying. Now, the base I have now isn't overly sticky. But here it is, the shade called Frigg. The next one is a shimmer, and it is called a River Glacier. And it is a white, shiny shade. So, dry first. Very, very nice. Now I'm going to spray, and how do I do that? I pick up shadow on my brush first, and then I spray with a bit of water. And it just makes it a little bit more intense. Oh, I hope salt and pepper isn't coming through on the camera, because the TV is on downstairs and I haven't closed my door. Here's the shade called River Glacier. The next shade is the shade called Hecla. It's really gripping the primer right now, which is good. Here it is. A nice... I don't know. Is it I think it's even a cooler toned orange. Very pretty though. Okay, next shade is the shade called Odin, which is a gray. But it is a little bit of a bluer gray. Looks a little bit greener on camera even. It's almost like the god itself. Kind of a chameleon. I'm using the same brush. I have a towel here. And a microfiber cloth that I clean the brush off in between. The shade Odin. Next two shades are shimmer, so I haven't put on any eye primer. My eye cream is still a tiny bit wet, but that's okay. That's not a problem with shimmers. So the first one is the shade called Alfheim. Where are we? There we are. Which is a duochrome. Dry first. But again, oh no, my eye cream is kind of set a bit. Let's spray it. Very, very pretty. The shade called Alfheim. Then the next shade is called God's Waterfall. Dry first. Oh, this is such a pretty shade. I've mentioned before that blues are not my favorite colors to work with, but these blues that are in here are grayer blues. And oh, so, so pretty. That is my kind of blue. I'm going to spray this as well. And it gets more intense, and this is also how it behaves on top of a glitter primer. God's Waterfall. The next shade is called Elves, and it is another duochrome. Let's spray. Very nice and shiny Elves. It still only counts as one. If you get the reference, let me know down below. Then the next shade is the shade called Muspelheim. Muspelheim. shade is the shade called Gallows Lava. Dry first. Such a pretty shade. Oh. Let's spray. Not a lot of difference. I just feel like it sticks a little bit better. It's a little bit more intense. Gallows Lava. Then the next shade is the shade Northern Lights. Dry first. Let's spray. Okay, so it's a little bit more green when you spray it. I don't know, I can clearly see the difference, but I don't know if you can. So here, basically this is the line, not sprayed, sprayed. Northern Lights. The next shade is the shade called Niflheim. And fun fact, I actually forgot to mention that I think on the palette the shade names are in English. But if you have the outer box, the names are in Icelandic. Let's go to the shade called Niflheim, which is Niflheimer, I think. I don't know. I'm not really... yeah, I can say it basically how I think I should say it, but it's... I don't think it's anywhere near the way that I should pronounce it. Let's just say that. This is a very, very pretty gray blue. It blends out beautifully. I'm not going to blend out now, but it blends out beautifully. I have used it in the multiple looks video. Looks messy now, but that's okay. Niflheim. The next shade is the shade called Njord. Or Njörder, I think. Am I pronouncing that correctly? I don't know. Why is my piercing? This is it. I usually pronounce it as Njord, but I don't think that's correct. Or maybe it's... I don't know. I'm trying here. This shade makes me happy. So pretty. Njord. Okay, let's next go to the Mother of the Dead, part of the dead. I know, the shade Hell. This is actually gorgeous as a blush. I have been using this as a blush in the multiple looks video. I have it as a blush today, or at least what is left of my blush. Very, very pretty. So yeah. And Hell is not as the biblical Hell. Hell is actually the name of the underworld goddess. And she takes care of the dead who reside in her realm, which are basically the normal dead, because the warrior dead go to Odin or they go to Freya. That's basically it. So they don't actually all end up in Valhalla. Fun fact. But yeah. And the other dead are in the underworld, and that is where the goddess Hel resides. She's actually the sun. Or the son, the daughter of Floki, or Loki, wow, thinking of my cat. But she's the daughter of Loki, in case you were wondering, and if you were not, now you know. So yeah, basically Marvel did not get it right at all, because Loki and Thor are not brothers. The shade Hell, it's so pretty. And then I'm going to go to the shade called Dark Castles. I would love to know how to pronounce this shade, or the names. This is such a gorgeous shade. I actually had this shade on my eyes today. Very dark, but very easy to work with. Dark Castles. And then there is one shade left. One shade left, I just prepped one eye. It's a shimmer, so there's no primer underneath, but it is called a Valkyries. And we in Dutch say Valkure. You say Valkyries, and here it is Valkyriur. I think we say Valkure. And those are the ladies who come and collect you from the battlefield. And one half goes to Odin, and the other half goes to Freya. Okay, I'm going to spray it. This one is a little bit looser almost in the pan. There is a purple shift in it, it looks like. This is actually the only shade and the shade Alfheim that I haven't used yet in an eyes in a look. So I will do that tomorrow. The shade Valkyrie. Is there also a red shift in here? It's very interesting. Very pretty. Let me go up a bit and chat a little bit with you about the palette and my thoughts so far, purely on the eye swatching part. What I noticed right away is the I do want to say that the kick up in the pan, the brushes that I actually used today didn't create as much kick up as some other brushes, but I have noticed the fluffier the brush, the more kick up you create, because you have a larger surface and it kind of pushes the eyeshadow loose. I hope that makes sense, but that is how I saw it. The mattes are very, very nice. You saw how they packed on. They pack on beautifully. The shade Frig has the most white in it because of its nature, but still, it is not... I don't really know how to explain what I want to explain, but basically if you have kind of a pastel shade that has too much white in it, I can see it and it emphasizes texture for me. This one does not, because for me at least it has the right amount of white. Just saying. Overall, the mattes packed on beautifully. I know that most blend out beautifully as well, even though I didn't do that, is because I want to spare my eyes a little bit for the last look for tomorrow. So yeah, usually I film an eye swatch video, I don't know, on Friday or on Saturday, that I can really give them a day to recover, but I don't have the time, because I just don't have the time. The shimmers, the shimmers perform beautifully as well, spraying or dry. In some shades it kind of gives you a difference, in other shades not so much. During the eye looks I do use a glitter primer most of the time though. This was it for the eye swatching part. I'm going to give you over to my tomorrow self for the overall review. So let's go to my thoughts on the palette. The mattes are basically the quality that I am used to from Nomad Cosmetics, and it is a quality that I really like, but I know that not everyone likes it, and maybe I can kind of help right now. What I have noticed with these shades, especially the lighter ones, that they need a sticky base to grip onto. I have tried this with different eyeshadow primers. Let me put it down the palette. I have tried the palette with different eyeshadow primers. The first primer I used was the one from Sigma. What I noticed with the one from Sigma, for me at least, is that it dried down too quickly. And some of the shades, especially the lighter shade, the shade Frick, did not have enough stickiness to grip to. So it wasn't as vibrant as it could have been. And I noticed it especially because I primed my eyes at the same time. I started with this eye, the base was still a little bit more sticky. And then when I went to this eye, I could tell that it had set a little bit more. And that it took me longer to build up the same intensity that I had here. So again, use something that is a little bit stickier. The Sigma primer was just a little bit too dry to really grip the lighter shades. You can layer the shades though. You can, but if you want the lighter shades to pop, make sure that they are on a sticky base. The second primer that I used was this primer from Catrice. That is, I don't think it's available in the US, but it is available in Europe. This is a very, very sticky primer, especially for me, because it takes almost ages to set. And after the, well, not really issue, but the experience I had with the Sigma primer, I was like, I want to try it with a base that stays sticky for longer. Let's see what it does then. And then I really noticed that you can get these shades so much more vibrant, because they really have something to stick to. And also, there is just something about this one that stays, even though I have basically set it with the first color eyeshadow, it is still sticky, especially here, where I then place the second shade or even the third shade, it stays sticky for longer. So this, if you can get your hands on this, this is a very, very nice primer to use with a formula like this. And That's it. So if you, I actually think that if you have Anastasia Beverly Hills palette and you have a primer that works very, very well with her mattes, it will work with this palette as well. I also tried it with the ABH primer and it worked with the ABH primer as well. However, I do feel, especially with that one too, it stays stickier for longer than the Sigma one, for me at least. But it also dried down quicker. Which isn't a bad thing, and because the base is so light in color, it makes the shadows pop a little bit more. But I just found that I prefer a base that is a little bit more sticky than the ABH one and the Sigma one. Maybe that can kind of help. The primer that I ended up liking the best with this palette is the one from Kiko. The one from Kiko is a primer that is, I think, available for most people. I know it's available in the US. I know it's available at least in Europe. You kind of have to see where Kiko wants to ship to, or if you can get Kiko Milano in your country. The reason that I like this base the best is, at least for me, it is the perfect balance between set and stickiness. So where I really like the stickiness of the Catrice one, because it stays sticky for quite some time, it makes it also a little bit harder to blend. And the Kiko one was the perfect in between for me. So it stayed sticky enough to pack on the lightest shade, and it was easy and or it set enough that I could easily blend as well. And it's not that these shadows are hard to blend, don't get me wrong, but because my eyes are older and the skin is a little bit looser, I want to blend as little as possible to make sure that this does not happen, you know, that, because I don't want that, I don't find that sexy. But yeah, so yeah, my recommendation for primer is one that is, that holds a certain amount of stickiness to grip the shadows, especially the first layer, and then especially the lightest shades that you have on your eyeballs. Yeah, in the eye swatches, you also heard me mention at the beginning that I use the Kiko Milano eye base. And it's also because it is, first of all, it's hydrating without being wet. It's just, I found at least, the perfect mix. So again, you don't need the Kiko Milano one. If you have a primer that works with the ABH formula, especially the mattes, it will work with this. If you have a formula that stays a little bit sticky but not too wet or not too sticky, that is basically what I'm trying to explain that the Kiko one does for me, at least. Unless my eyes are very, very dry, then that dries down as well. But yeah, so those were the mattes. You can blend them, you can layer them. I have layered, I think, 4 on top of each other, and it stuck no problem. Even here in my problem areas, it stuck. Then let's go to the shimmers that are in here. You saw me in the eye swatching part use them dry and then spray them. In the eye looks, I used them with a glitter primer, except look number 4, I used the shade Gallows Lava. So this one I used to dry on my lid, and it is perfect for that. But they stick dry. If you want them a little bit more intense, use a glitter primer or spray your brush. But even if you don't use a glitter primer, they have enough binder in them to stick, and they're just very, very pretty. There are no satins in here. For me personally, these are not your very, very extremely foiled shadows, especially this one, for which I am very glad. Because, and I have said this before, if I have a shadow, especially a silver or a white, if I have a shadow that is extremely foiled, it gives me more texture on my eyelids. And it almost creates texture, if that makes any sense at all. So for me, this is the perfect in-between. So it is a very, it's not extremely foiled, but it is very nice and shimmery. You can, if you use it dry, make it less intense. If you spray it or use a glitter primer, it becomes more intense. Very, very pretty. Let's see. Then we have the shade Elves is a duochrome. The shade Gallows Lava is also, yeah, when I look at it, it looks like a dirty gold, but it has a lot more depth in it than you would think, because I can also see some green in there. I can see some gray. It's basically a combination almost of these three. Then Alfheim is a gray base with a pinky purple shimmer, and I have that on my lid today. And then the shade Valkyrie is, it kind of looks blue when I look at it, but then when I turn the palette, it becomes purple. I don't know if you can see that, but it becomes purple. And it also has some different shimmery goodness thingamajingies in there. This is just such a unique color story for my, I think actually for any collection. The blues that are in here, I did a monochromatic blue look and it was so, so pretty. These are my type of blues, and I have said it before, blue is not my favorite color to work with. There are specific kinds of tones of blue that I like and that I find look very pretty and most flattering on me, and that is basically what this is. The grayer toned blues I find more flattering on me than the almost the more purpley blues or the more inky blues, you know. It's, yeah, that's it. And I hope that I show you, especially in the looks, how to basically combine this palette, make colorful combinations, especially, for instance, the combination that I have on my eyes today is maybe not something that you would think to do. It's actually the shade Hecla. Then I deepened it up with Odin, and then I put Alfheim on my lid, and Valkyrie is the one around it, and then I put elves in the inner corner, and it is just such a fun, colorful look that you may not have thought of when you saw this palette. Overall, I think you can kind of guess. I think it's worth the money. Me personally, I love Nomad Cosmetics. I love their formula. I love the color stories. I love the fact that they also always create something hidden extra in the colors that they use. I just love everything about it. And I hope that I helped you figure out if this is a formula that you love as well. If you have trouble working with mattes like this, the softer mattes, as I said, don't set your, or I don't think I said that, but try to use your primer not set. Make sure that you tap it out with your fingers, because that can help as well. That you don't have enough, that you have an even layer everywhere, and you need a base that is a little bit, stays sticky for a little bit longer than, for instance, for me at least, the Sigma one or the MAC Paint Pot, because they dry pretty quickly for me. Yes, you need a base that stays a little bit sticky for a little bit longer. That is my tip. And yeah, let me know down below if you want the palette, if you're going to snag the palette. It will release tomorrow. I have already said that, I think, in the beginning, but to remind you, it will release tomorrow. I don't know the exact time though. I will list that in the description box and I will link their site. You can use my code NIKKI10 if you want to save 10%. It's not affiliated, but it will save you some money. And then make sure before you go that you have hit the subscribe button and the bell button, so you will be notified when the multiple looks video goes online tomorrow, to give you some extra inspiration and to really see how it performs while doing a look. Because I can tell you it performed beautifully, but usually seeing is believing, you know. Don't take my word for it. Go watch tomorrow's video. And that is going to be it for today. Let me go to the side and give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to my merch shop, and there will be timestamps, discount codes, and all that. I will leave my iSwatch playlist, or my swatching playlist, on the end screen, and I will leave my Nomad Cosmetics playlist in the description box, so you have options. That is it, guys. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I hope to see you tomorrow for the multiple looks video. Bye, guys.